Silk, the most beautiful of the natural fibers, is acclaimed as the queen of textile fibers. Silk is the only truly mystery and adventure. It is also a highly valuable textile fiber having unique technical and user-friendly characteristics. The queen of textiles has remained unmatched in her beauty, feel, and other user-friendly properties. Silk, called the queen of fibers, is a continuous protein fiber produced by the silkworm so as to form its cocoon. The silk fiber is also produced by some spiders belonging to the Arachnida family. Unlike the silkworm fiber, the spider fiber cannot be commercially produced, and therefore the silk fiber referred in this topic is the fiber coming from the silkworm. In a world which emphasizes ease and speed, often sacrificing quality for convenience, it is important to balance your knowledge with an elegant, beautiful subject such as silk. Why do we say only silk is silk? Because there is no other fiber which can match its combined performance of look, feel, of wear. Silk is a miracle of nature which over the centuries has defied duplication by man. Silk was discovered by a teenager, a little Chinese empress named Shi Zi Ling Shi. While walking in her garden, one day she spied a small white cocoon growing on a mulberry branch. She brought the cocoon into her room and while examining it, accidentally dropped into a basin of hot water. Suddenly, a wispy filament began to unwind from the cocoon. Zi Ling Shi thought this strange substance would make a beautiful rope. She called in the court weaver, and so silk was born. Zi Ling Shi inspired the first silk fashion in 2640 BC. For nearly 3000 years after that, China kept the secret of sericulture, the cultivation of silkworms, and monopolized the silk trade. Then a few silkworm eggs were smuggled into Japan, and the leading producer of raw silk fiber. Though history of silk has been a treasured fiber, the Greeks moved their finest togas of silk. During Julius Caesar regime, it was literally worth its weight in gold. The nobility of the Byzantine, Renaissance, and Tudor periods favored silk, and the early American colonists wore it as a status symbol. Silk remains queen of fibers and is more desired in the Far East, Europe, and America than ever before. The silk fiber is a natural animal fiber. Unlike wool, silk contains a very small amount of a sulfur. There are two main types of silkworm: mulberry silkworm, that is Bombyx mori, also called cultivated silk, and wild silk, of which tussar silk is the most important representative. Mulberry silk is produced by silkworm larvae cultivated in provided habitats and fed with freshly picked mulberry leaves. Cultivated silk is different from tussar silk, native to China and India, in that tussar silk is fed almost only on oak leaves. Cultivated silks are fine, almost white when degummed, and soft filaments with lustrous. Nearly 80 to 85% of the world silk production consists of cultivated silks. While wild silk are coarser, more irregular, and brownish in appearance, they are never as white as the cultivated silk filament. Mulberry silk and non-mulberry silk. In non-mulberry silk, tussar, eri and muga. The silk produced by feeding mulberry leaves are called mulberry silk. Non-mulberry silk is cultivated in the forests. India is the only country producing all four types of silk. Coming to the mulberry silk, the bulk of commercial silk produced in the world comes from this variety, and often silk generally refers to mulberry silk. Mulberry silk comes from the silkworm Bombyx mori, gel, which slowly feeds on the leaves of mulberry plant. These silkworms are completely domesticated and reared indoors. In India, the major mulberry silk producing states are Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, and Jammu and Kashmir, which together accounts for 92% of country's total mulberry raw silk production. Coming to the tussar, tussar or tusha is copperish color coarse silk mainly used for furnishings and interiors. It is less lustrous than mulberry silk but has its own feel and appeal. Tussar silk is generated by the silkworm Antheria milita, which mainly thrive on food plants Asan and Arjuna. The rearings are conducted in nature on the trees in the open. In India, tussar silk is mainly produced in the states of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Orissa. Besides Maharashtra, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh, tussar culture is mainstay for many a tribal community in India. Coming to the another non-mulberry silkworm, eri. Eri, also known as endi or erandi. Eri is a multivoltin silk spun for open cocoon. Unlike other varieties of silk, eri silk is product of the domesticated silkworm Philosomia resini that feeds mainly on castor leaves. Agriculture is a household activity practiced mainly for protein rich pupae, a delish kesi for the tribal. Resultantly, the eri cocoons are open mouthed and are spun. The silk is used indigenously for preparation of chadas, that is wraps, for own use by those tribals. In India, this culture is practiced mainly in the northeastern states and Assam. It is also found in Bihar, West Bengal and Orissa. Coming to the another non-mulberry silkworm, muga, this golden yellow color silk is prerogative of India and the pride of Assam state. It is obtained from semi-domesticated multivoltin silkworm Antheria assamensis. These silkworms feed on the aromatic leaves of som and solu plants and are reared on trees similar to that of tussar. Muga culture is specific to the state of Assam and an integral part of tradition and culture of that state. The muga silk, an high value product, is used in products like saris, mehkals, chandras, etc. The spinning process of silkworm has been described earlier. The mature silkworm builds its cocoon by extruding a viscous fluid from two large glands in the body of the silkworm. This solution is extracted through two ducts in the head of the silkworm into a common spinneret. The viscous part, that is fibrin, is covered by another secretion, that is sericin, which follows from two other symmetrically placed glands. These two components are cemented together by emerging into the air, coagulating and producing a firm continuous filament. As a consequence of this spinning process, the fiber has two main parts called sericin and fibrin. Sericin, called silk gum, is a major component of the fiber, that is 25% of the weight of the silk, and it is also has some impurities such as waxes, fats, pigments. Sericin is a yellow, brittle and inelastic substance. It acts as an adhesive for the twin fibrin filaments and conceals the uniculuster of fibrin. Sericin is known as an amorphous structure and it is dissolved in a hot soap solution. Komastu claimed that sericin may be separated into sericin 1, 2, 3 and 4 by using their different solubilities in hot water and assessing the degree of solubility by UV absorption. The grated sericin content is present in the outer layer of the cocoon, whereas the least sericin proportion is present in the innermost layer of the cocoon. Fibrin is the principal water soluble protein that constitutes of 78% of the weight of raw silk. Fibrin has a highly oriented and crystalline structure. Microfibrils are packed together to form the fibril bundle, and several fibril bundles produce a single strand. Fibrin has a high portions of alanine, glycine and serine. A small amount of cysteine residues gives a very small amount of sulfur in the fiber. Fibrin contains only a small amount of amino acids which have acid side chains. The amount of basic side groups in fibrin is relatively low. Because of this, the amount of acid and alkali that can be absorbed by silk are relatively lower than those absorbed by wool. Hydrogen bonding is important in fibrin. X-ray structural analysis of the crystalline domains of fibrin show that the peptide chains pack in fully extended forms. The cross section of raw silk is roughly elliptical. It shows the triangular twin fibrin filaments completely covered by sericin, which normally face each other. After the debugging process, the two triangular fibrin filaments is called brins, separate into individual filaments giving different fiber geometry from the raw silk, that is a finer fiber and a more lustrous fiber. So, coming to the shape and appearance of silk, silk filaments are approximately 900 to 1700 meters long. The diameter of the silk filament is from 9 to 11 microns. A raw cultivated silk is off white to yellow in color, unlike cultivated silk. Wild silks are uneven, brown and slightly less lustrous than those from cultivated. This figure is an X-ray photograph of a small bundle about 1 millimeter thick of parallel silk fibrin fibers. It shows that fibrin consists of non-crystalline and crystalline regions. The crystalline region tends to be oriented along the fiber axis because the fiber is drawn as it is extruded from the spinnerets of the silkworm. Coming to the hygroscopic nature, the conventional moisture regain of silk is about 11% compared with the mercerized cotton fiber, which has conventional moisture regain capacity of 10.5%. The amount of moisture absorbed by silk is dependent on its previous history, such as whether it is raw or degummed silk, on the species of silk as well as on the atmospheric humidity. Coming to the tensile properties, silk fiber is extremely strong. A filament of silk is stronger than an equal diameter filament of steel. Normally, the dry silk fiber has a tenacity varying from 2.4 to 5.1 grams per denier. The wet strength of the fiber is about to 80 to 85% of the dry strength. Coming to the elongation, elongation at break of silk filament is around 20 to 25% under normal conditions. The extension at break is 33% at 100% relative humidity. Coming to the specific gravity of silk, specific gravity of raw cultivated silk and raw tussar silk are 1.33 and 1.32 gram per centimeter square respectively. On the other hand, weighed silk has specific gravity more than 1.60 gram per centimeter square. Effect of heat on silk. Silk fiber heated at 140 degree centigrade remains unaffected for a long period of time, but it is decomposed very quickly at 175 degree centigrade or more. Effect of UV radiation. The strength and elongation of silk fibrin fibers are decreased when the fibers are exposed to the UV radiation. The degree of the crystallinity was not affected by the radiation treatment. Silk is not dissolved by water at room temperature, but may lose weight in boiling water or steam at 100 degree Celsius. Coming to the effect of acids and alkalis on silk, acids and alkalis cause hydrolysis of the polypeptide chains in the fiber. It has been claimed that pH values between 4 and 8 causes the least damage to the fiber. Acid hydrolysis tends to be more damaging to the fiber than alkali hydrolysis. Acid hydrolysis occurs at nearly all the peptide linkages in the chain, while alkali hydrolysis firstly attacks at the end of the peptide chains. Concentrated sulfuric acid and hydrochloric acid well dissolved the fiber. Nitric acid color silk yellow. Dilute acids do not attack the fiber under mild conditions. Strong hot caustic alkalis will readily dissolve the fiber. Weak alkalis such as soap, borax and ammonia normally dissolve sericin, but they also attack fibrin when the treatment time at boiling point is prolonged. Coming to the effect of oxidizing agents, oxidation reactions are very complex and are considered to take place at the side chains of tyrosine, the amino terminal residues of the main chains and at the peptide bonds. Fibrin is highly vulnerable to oxidizing agents. Therefore, care must be taken when bleaching the fiber. Hydrogen peroxide and some pre-acids are normally used in the bleaching process of raw silk. It has been found that pre-acetic acid causes a more destructive effect with fibrin than hydrogen peroxides. Coming to the effect of reducing agents, it is known that fibrin resists the reducing agents such as hydrosulfides, sulfuric acid and its salts. Silk, the fashion fiber. The world's leading countries and interior decorates receive much of the inspiration for their greatest designs from the fibers which they work. That is the reason that magnificent silk is so important to Paris, Rome, New York and California. Coming to the silk fashions for daytime and evening dresses, dresses coats and suits and also sports wears will also be used. All girls and women love the look, feel, wear of silk. No other fabric gives such a true sense of luxury. Daytime dresses are in shantung, jersey, tushart, silk linen, faillin and prints. Evening dresses are in chiffon, crepe, taffeti, PCD, soyi and satin. Coats and suits from silk in silk linen, faillin, brocades and mixed with worsted. Sports wears in shunting, twill, prints, silk linen and tushash. Silk fashion for life greatest moments, that is bridal, graduation, communication, christening. Silk for the most important occasions in your life when elegance is mandatory. Silk is appropriate, beautiful for the dress you will always remember. For centuries, silk has been handed down in cherished heirloom, bridal grooms, communion and christening dresses. Gowns in PUD soyi, fellil, lace, organza, chiffon, taffeta, barcode satin and velvet. Veils in silk tulle are illusion. Silk fashion for accessories like hat scarves, handbags, shoes, umbrellas. Accessories can make the difference between just a dress and a costume. True fashion taste is proven by the ways clothes are accessorized. Hat in chiffon, satin, stunting twill and to match. Scarves in chiffon, satin, twill, China silk and prints. Handbags in satin, stang, faillin and made to match. Umbrella is silk, broad cloth and prints. Coming to the silk fashion for men like suits, shirts, accessories, pyjamas and robes. Silk adds distinction to any man's appearance and because of its neutral reliance wears and travels like a dream. Picking creases hang out a few hours. Suitings in silk linen, shunting, tushart and silk and worsted. Shirts in silk broadcloth and tushash. Tie in reeps, shantung, tushash, shurab dupian and satin. Kerchiefs and scarves in reeps, knits, surash, satin and prints. Robes in broadcloth, surah, satin, brocade coat, twill and prints. Pyjamas in broadcloth, shantung, satin and prints. Silk fashion for home decorating. Drapes effortlessly, spreads and cushions. The lustrous long wearing qualities of silk make it the perfect fabric for home decorating. Interesting textures with hand woven, scrubbed or antique effects are used by famous decorators and furniture manufacturers to enhance every room in the home. Because silk takes dye so well, its brilliance can provide a much needed color accent. Drapes made of silk can achieve for maximum service. Silk drapes should be laid for the bedroom is symptoms drapes and spreads for the living room in drapes, upholstery and cushions. Silk is called queen of fibers because of the man effort to make by man-made fibers to reach the characters or to obtain the characters of the silk is not still possible. A natural protein fiber is called queen of textile fibers.